This video is about basic concepts of organometallic chemistry, covering ligand types, bonding and geometries of organometallic compounds. Organometallic chemistry looks at reactions between inorganic metals and organic groups. We'll go through the contents of the Unit 1 of Organometallic Chemistry course, CHU 3127. Organometallic compounds are widely used in industries to carry out various transformations. The enthusiasm of them increased with the discovery of the metallocene, ferrocene, in 1950. In ferrocene, the metal center is sandwiched between two organic cyclopentadienyl ligands. Compounds containing cyclopentadienyl ligands are used for the polymerization of olefins. Let's take a closer look at another popular metallocene. It consists of a manganese metal center and some coordinated ligands. An organic cyclopentadienyl ligand covers one face of the metal like a half sandwich. Three organic carbonyl ligands are attached from the other side, like that of in a piano stool. Organic ligands are important in the sense that they form bonds with metals. They are metal-carbon bonds. Generally, an organometallic compound is a compound containing organic ligands with at least one metal to carbon bond. Therefore, this complex is called an organometallic compound. Here are some of the organic ligands: methyl, phenyl, vinyl, ethene, cyclopentadienyl. However, we frequently meet other ligands such as dinitrogen, nitrosyl, phosphine, and hydride attached to the metal center. Here are some of the examples of organometallic compounds. The properties of organometallic compounds depend on the metal atom and the nature of coordinated ligands. Ligands are classified into three main types: monoheptoligands, polyheptoligands, bridging ligands. Carbonyl ligand is attached only through one carbon atom to the manganese metal atom. So, it is called a monoheptoligand. Chlorophenyl mercury contains a monoheptophenyl group. Tetramethyl lead contains four monoheptomethyl ligands. A polyheptoligand is defined as a ligand that forms more than two attachments to the metal. Benzene ligand is attached through six of its carbon atoms to a single metal atom. So, benzene is called a polyheptoligand. Trichlorodiheptoethene platinate contains a diheptoethene ligand. In this case, butadiene ligand is tetraheptoligand. Hapticity of a ligand is very important in classifying ligands. Hapticity is the number of adjacent atoms of a ligand which are directly bonded to the metal atom. Benzene is a hexaheptoligand. 6 adjacent carbon atoms of benzene are directly bonded to the metal. It is indicated by the Greek letter eta, followed by the superscript number 6. Benzene ligand reacts with the carbon ion to generate a new compound. Now, the ligand is attached through only 5 carbon atoms and the hepticity has changed from 6 to 5. Sigma allyl ligand is directly bonded to the metal atom through 1 carbon atom. So, it is an eta 1 ligand. The hepticity is 1. But in a pi allyl ligand, all 3 carbon atoms are bonded to the metal center. The hepticity now is 3. Sigma allyl and pi allyl ligands are interconvertible to each other. Can you notice the methyl ligands which have created a bridge linking two aluminium atoms? Methyl is acting as a bridging ligand. As an example, now let's draw the structure of carbonyl, eta-3 cyclopentadienyl, eta-5 cyclopentadienyl ion. Ion is the metal center. Eta-5 cyclopentadienyl ligand combines through all the carbon atoms. Eta-3 cyclopentadienyl ligand connects through 3 carbon atoms. There is only 1 carbonyl ligand. Most of the transition metals form metal-carbon bonds with organic ligands. We are familiar with concepts like the electron configuration of a metal atom. Group number of a transition metal is equal to the sum of s and d electrons in the zero valent metal atom. For example, the electron configuration of zero valent titanium is argon 4s2 3d2. When the metal is accompanied by ligands, its d orbital is lower in energy than the s orbital. Now, the configuration is considered as argon 4s0 3d4 and assigned as a group 4 element. Coordination number can be defined as the number of monodentate ligands or electron pairs coordinated to a metal. Let's consider diethyl zinc. It is a linear molecule. Here, 2 monodentate ligands or electron pairs are coordinated to the metal. Therefore, coordination number is 2. And the geometry is linear. In this compound, 3 eta 2 ethene ligands had donated 3 electron pairs to the metal. Therefore, coordination number is 3 and geometry is trigonal planar. Two geometries are possible with the coordination number 4. Square planar. Tetrahedral. Two types of geometries are found for the coordination number 5 as well. They are trigonal bipyramidal and square pyramidal. Compounds with coordination number 6 show an octahedral geometry. What is the maximum number of atoms that can be coordinated to a metal? A transition metal has 1 s orbital, 3 p orbitals, and 5 d valence orbitals. Altogether, there are 9 valence orbitals. Therefore, the maximum coordination number for a transition metal is 9. This is achieved with small ligands like hydride in nonohydrorenate. Valence electron count is equal to the sum of d electrons in the metal center and the electrons donated by ligands. There are 2 models to calculate the valence electron count. They are ionic model and covalent model. Electronegativity of a transition metals increases from left to right. Early transition metals in higher oxidation states are electropositive and called hard metals. Late transition metals in zero or lower oxidation states are more electronegative and called soft metals. Let's look at how a metal ligand bond is formed. Some ligands can donate a pair of electrons or a lone pair to a vacant orbital of a transition metal center. The resulting bond is called a sigma bond. Some of the ligands can accept pi electrons from the metal center. Such ligands are called pi acceptors. For example, carbonyl. This process of donating pi electrons in the metal orbitals to an empty orbital of the ligand is known as the back donation or back bonding. In this video, we have discussed the basic concepts of organometallic chemistry. We hope you have got an insight into the bonding in organometallic compounds.